the Mitsubishi Challenge. Proudly brought to you by Chicken Treat. I've got the taste. Coca-Cola. Always jammin', always Coca-Cola. Ian Diffin, World of Tires. McDonald's, where it's Mac time. And Mitsubishi, please consider.
Here we go.
Wildcats are back home, albeit having lost three of their last four games either side of the Olympic break. Whereas tonight's visitors, the Geelong Supercats, are rated the most improved team of the Mitsubishi Challenge. It's a case of depth and experience pitted against good old-fashioned country enthusiasm. As the Perth Wildcats host the Geelong Supercats.
Wildcats action is back in the West. The Perth Wildcats at home for the first time since the Olympic break. Their opposition, as you heard, the much improved Geelong Supercats. It's great to be back with you from the Perth Entertainment Centre, and we are excited about tonight's game right around the country. And it's our first look, John Gardner, at Todd Lichty as far as local fans are concerned. 17 of 18, the Wildcats have beaten Geelong in the past. Going to be close though.
Well, I think it has to be close, Tim, and the Wildcats would be well advised not to take Geelong easily in the first game between these two clubs in the Mitsubishi Challenge. The Wildcats led well at three-quarter time, and Geelong came back in the last quarter. And one of the keys for that game, as will be the keys for this, was that the Wildcats need to stop the outside shooting from Geelong. They also must make sure that Ray Oz doesn't control the paint and the backboards. And of course, from the Geelong club's point of view, they need to stop Perth's inside power game, and as they are one of the worst fouling teams in the league, they need to do it without fouling.
Todd Lichty is certainly one of the stars of the NBL already. He's only been in it a week, and Pete Hansen, Mike Ellis is an old face, but I reckon most of the crowd here want to see Lichty in action.
Well, they certainly do, and rightly so, Tim. He is a very exciting player. You can just see the NBA experience in him, the way he reads the game, the way he plays, and just having a look at his stats there. In the two games that whilst they were away last weekend, he was the game-high scorer in both. He's averaged that. He's already first in the league as the most efficient player, and that's all, you know, he's just a very exciting player. He's got some good stats there. Look at his opposite number for tonight, though, and we've got Ray Oz. This man, also a Californian, he is a very exciting player. In actual fact, his last three games, he's averaged 30 points at 69%. He's first in the league in rebounding and fourth in block shots. He is someone who is going to be very, very tough for the Wildcats to contain tonight.
For the Wildcats tonight, Lichty steps into the lineup at that small forward role. Of course, Ricky Grace runs the ball from the point. Trahair making sure that he can add points production. Vlahov returning after the Olympic campaign. And the perennial, James Crawford, they complete the starting five for the Wildcats.
For the Supercats, the two bombers at the guard spot, Curl and Williams, look to those guys to light up from outside. Scalzi, Sapwell, and the big man in the middle, Ray Oz.
For the Wildcats, the longest bench they've had for some time. Doherty, Gardner, Stewart. Big Pete Hansen comes back in for the first time. Vanderputten completes the bench.
And for the Supercats, the Terminator, Big Svel Dennis, Mr. Grabeau, Leonard Exum, and Mike Virtue.
So the wait is over for local fans. The Wildcats, the defending champions, back in commission. Head-to-head, John Gardner does favour the Wildcats and fairly dominant in recent times.
There's no doubt that Wildcats deserve favouritism here, but they haven't enjoyed the best of seasons on this, their home court. Somewhat a little bit of an enigma so far this year as Sapwell takes Vlahov to the rack. Lichty comes up with his first rebound in front of his adopted crowd.
Lichty Grace, here's Vlahov. Bounce pass, posting up. Crawford in off the glass. Travel's been called by referee Michael Button.
A bit of a drag on the baseline, or the pivot foot, I should say. Just dragged it, tried to fake a few too many times there.
Great matchup out here, Tim, with James Crawford on Ray Oz. They are talking in Geelong about the second coming of James Crawford per the medium of Ray Oz, because he's leading Geelong in rebounding and very near their leading scorer, as indeed
James Crawford is their leading all-time scorer and rebounder.
John, earlier this year, we were in Geelong, a memorable experience it was too, when the Wildcats got over the line by 6 points.
And they only just got there, and the Wildcats would be well advised, as we said earlier, to not take this team easy. Tim, this team has had an excellent Olympic break. They played a few games, and there were a few games played in the Mitsubishi Challenge during that break. They had a much, much better record. Had an abysmal start, lost something like 9 or 10 on the trot, but they're starting to come good at the business end of the season.
And Orlando Williams has joined the team since then. For three, Trehair, the score is the Wildcats 3-0.
That is a great start for Aaron Trehair, because the Wildcats need to build a much better shooting percentage than what they did last week in their last outing, which was a loss to the Magic, where the team shot at 38 and of course Trehair shot at 18%.
Scalzi for the response, doesn't go, and Vlahov hits the boards again.
Lichty in the lineup now. It'd be great for the fans to see Lichty, 5 years in the NBA, played at Stanford during his college years with Andrew Vlahov, hence the connection to Perth. And he's a very fine athlete.
Mike Ellis-Lichty is also very deceptively big across the shoulders as he drives through the keyway. Left hand doesn't go.
He is. He's a very, very strong man. In fact, in the weight room, he benches probably as much, if not more, than anyone else in the team. He is very, very strong.
There is Williams. Well done, Crawford. Got in front of O's, but the Geelong Supercats will come up with the ball.
Tentative start from both clubs. Wildcats lead by the solitary three-pointer. Pertra here. O's out in the perimeter. Crawford watching. Scalzi, Williams. He's a pocket dynamo, isn't he? Puts the ball to the floor and pulls up the left-hand shot, and it's all net.
So Orlando Williams gets the Geelong Supercats on the board, and it's 3-3. Drive by Grace.
Will pick the pocket, but really couldn't do much with it. Michael Butler signals the way it should go. Michael Butler returning from the Olympic campaign, where he did officiate on behalf of Australia. Great experience for Michael.
So it's 3-3 here at the Perth Entertainment Centre. Hope you're enjoying the action around the country, especially down there in Geelong. Your team's, I'm sure, going to give a good account of yourself. There's Curl. Bounce past Sapwell. Easy as you like.
Good offence. Probing. Committed the man. Found the bucket, pull-up jump shot from Lichty, found the window, pops in for two. Lichty matching up on Curl. That'll be a great challenge for Curl. Simon Curl's not one to back off from that either. He'll certainly come up with a few explosive moves out there.
Scored 27 for Geelong. Back in April, and these two teams met. Steal by Grace, has some assistance, Lichty and Trehair. Layup for here. He has five. His team has seven. They lead by two.
Our defense will be the key to this match. Geelong are not a big team, but they're well drilled. Ian Stacker, their coach, is also the head coach for Australia's under-23 national men's team for the World Under-23s being held in Melbourne next August. So he's got some good young people with him.
Vlahov, and will only get better from the Olympic break. Needed a freshener. Trehair, great look pass now to Vlahov, posting up for two.
Yeah, drew the defence. It's marvellous what a penetrating dribble can do for you, Michael.
Makes a big difference, certainly, and Vlahov knows that if his man goes to help, he finds the hole, and Trehair will just get him the ball.
Just a reminder, no Scott Fisher for the Wildcats. Well done, Sapwell. Layup from his ankle, John Gardner.
He's strong, Sapwell. He played with Stacker at the Melbourne Magic for a number of years. A very strong, experienced ball player.
Posting up Lichty on Scalzi. Bounce pass. Crawford through traffic.
Scalzi did well to help. James Crawford had to take a little pump fake in the air then, but he came up with the goods. 11 plays, 7.
He jumped and then decided what he was going to do with it after he was up there. Gee, it must be nice to be able to do that.
Have a timeout at the Perth Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats lead 11, Geelong 7. And as I said, no Scott Fisher here, guys, and obviously injured his knee early in the game against Hobart and didn't play against the Magic last week.
No, I believe the word is not as tragic as we thought it may be, because it's the knees that really worry people as opposed to the ankles, I guess.
Well, that's right. He tore the collateral ligament in the inside of his left knee. The initial thought was that he'd be out for some time. The physio that was with us, Noel McRoberts, was a little concerned about it. He was limping quite severely on the on the knee, but then it came good and he was all right, you know. He looks okay.
Ricky Grace looks okay too, Mike, and also Aaron Trehair, who has scored 5 in this early section of the game, John Gardner.
Well, there's Scott Fisher, the man in question. We believe it might be a plot to give him a break after that Olympic campaign. He won't quite own up to it, but of course there's nothing as depressing as seeing a top player sitting in the middle of the court there, and you know it's just more than a tweak on the ankle.
You know Scott will do just about anything for attention, so you know, maybe that's the case.
Ian Stacker in picture there. He's called the timeout. He's not going to let the Wildcats break away. I suspect anything more than a 3 or 4 point margin, he will call the timeout. Rayo's in picture, has been a revelation in Geelong this year, really leading the league in rebounding with 13, scoring at about a 21-point clip. He's doing very, very well.
Well, on the subject of Geelong, good evening to Bree Dempsey. I received a letter from one of my great fans from Geelong. I've got plenty, John, around the country.
I can believe it.
Young Bree is a mad Ricky Grace fan, but she barracks for Geelong. She also loves Ben Allen from the AFL, so she's in love with everyone, and you too, Mike.
Oh, that's good. She's a lovely, lovely girl.
Bree Dempsey. Here's Williams for 3.
Not so good that time, but Sapwell got it back and puts in the second putback for him. Good start for Rupert Sapwell. Not a prolific scorer. Already has 6. And he really has only been averaging 11. So he's doing enough to suggest that he will go past that tonight.
Posting up high post, Trehair looking for someone back door. Gives it to a little give pass to Blau. Easy as a lot. Finger roll for 2.
Good offense. Little elbow entry there with the backdoor play from Vlahov. There's another steal. Lichty got to the hand and then Crawford mops it up. Grace at the point. Ricky Grace dispossessed here and Williams comes down. He's a left-hander, remember. He passes it off.
Oh, great reject.
Well,
thanks for coming.
Other end of Vlahov.
Actually, there was eye contact between Trehair and Vlahov. I'm not sure Vlahov was saying throw that alley-oop pass. I think he was just mentioning that it might be a possibility.
Huge block by Crawford. Off the screen, Trehair. Shot was short. Good rebound, Sapwell.
I expect to see a lot of competitive action from James Crawford. I made mention earlier the fact that James Crawford, during his years with Geelong, did accumulate enough points and rebounds to be their all-time star in both of those categories, so he's going to take it rather personally if Ray Owes does anything too much.
Well, he certainly took that last shot personally. Boy, did he get up after that. And I would say that Owes will be now thinking, I think I might have to put a bit more on those shots from now on.
He can do it though, Mike. We've watched him play before. That's got to be offensive, I would think.
Oh, and he's got the call. Yeah. John's called it from the sideline. I don't know about the angle, but hey.
He was there and there for a long time, and I guess he paid the price.
Here's that huge block by James Crawford as we have another timeout at the Perth Wildcats Entertainment Centre. They lead 13-9.
One of the greatest actors of our time in one of the greatest performances.
You got me all misty eyed.
Al Pacino in his Oscar-winning role with Batman Forever's Chris O'Donnell.
I can't go to New York City.
By Sunday night, you'll be best friends.
The story of an unlikely partnership and an unforgettable journey.
It's a great day for moving along.
For the first time on television.
Would you like to learn to tangle?
Right now.
The sensational box office smash.
Oh, but I still smell her.
Ooh, mama.
Scent of a Woman. 8:30 Sunday on 10.
Hoo-ah!
Volvo owners know the importance of having the best quality fail-safe equipment. That's why Volvo owners internationally are changing to Maxxis steel radial tyres. Exclusively available from Ian Diffen World of Tyres and Mufflers.
With side intrusion bars built into every Pajero, you can rest assured the great outdoors stays outdoors. Please consider.
How can I help you?
No, choose the cheese, the choosy cheese.
Choose the chosen cheese.
No. Choose the cheesy lovers that the true cheese lovers.
No.
Cheesy cheese.
Right now at McDonald's, if you order a triple cheeseburger and can say the triple cheese tongue twister, you'll get a free small Coke and a chance to win AFL Grand Final tickets.
Cheesy cheese.
McDonald's Triple Cheese Challenge. It's really cheesy.
Cheesy cheese.
History repeats with Enzo. Split Ends with the New Zealand Symphony Orchestra deliver a timeless classic. All of Split Ends' greatest hits featuring Neil and Tim Finn. now from Wesley CD Megastore.
I'm like a complete idiot of myself.
No, you're cute.
I'm John Travolta.
You lie all the time.
I've wings over everything else.
Geelong Supercats have crossed the highway and are in Perth tonight, and they're up against the Perth Wildcats, only 13-9. Mike Ellis.
Just having a listen to Adrian Hurley, they're quite happy with the intensity of the way things are going. He wants the defensive intensity to continue, and he made a sub with Stewart coming in for Trehair to keep that defensive pressure up.
Posting up strong, Crawford almost open. Mismatch there with him and Williams. Vlahov off the dribble for two, doesn't go. Numbers and positions favour Geelong. It should be a Perth ball.
Well, Andrew Vlahov certainly got after the shot, and I suspect Orlando Williams just pulled the head in there. He was afraid of that great looping left arm of Vlahov. Andrew Vlahov looks a little fresher, Mike, as you would expect. Certainly fresher than what he was last weekend.
Well, he was a bit disappointed with the way he was playing last weekend, and he wants to make amends for that. Andrew's a true professional, and he certainly wants to lift his game.
They besiege Lichty.
Yes, certainly his reputation's gone before him, hasn't there? Were three coming over to help.
I thought Andrew Vlahov might have had a few excuses last week. Would have been a tad tired, one would assume. But it's nice to get in his own bed.
But I think he wondered which state he was actually in.
Yeah, it's a big campaign. A really big ask if you look at the campaign that he had leading up to that program as well. Good hand there by Ricky Grace. Got onto Williams.
As Williams again, screen set by Sapwell. Grace goes by, the shot is short. Well done, Sapwell, the follower.
Oh, thank you very much.
It's his eighth point, and that's the third putback. So somebody has to do a little better job on blocking him away, checking him away from the backboards, and there's a steal, and Geelong are back with Scalzi. Crawford's taken the steal now instead of the block. Scalzi's recovered and come back 13 apiece. Just under 5 minutes remaining to quarter time, and it's all tied up.
I think some adjustments, gentlemen, are going to happen defensively. I think you'll find Vlahov's got Sapwell, but he's doing a fair amount of sagging off to help on O's with Crawford down there, and Sapwell's starting to go off. So you'll see a bit more adjustment from Vlahov, I'd suggest now.
We might also see, in fact, we will see Pete Hansen checking into the game. Here's Lichty to Crawford. Swipe came from Curl. They open up for him quite nicely. Hand in Sapwell. Crawford back to Vlahov. Stewart for three.
Not a pretty offense, but it's got the points.
What do they say, John? Ugly but effective.
Yeah, we'll take the points, and we'll talk about the offense later. Pete Hansen comes onto the floor at the moment as James Crawford sits down. Pete Hansen reappearing on the regular roster for the first time since 1992. Last year, of course, he was activated with an injury that the Wildcats had, and he played just the one game in replacing an injured player, but he's back on the roster now for the remainder of the season.
16-13. He's Exum. High post, Curl. Screen set by Exum to get rid of Stewart doesn't work. Vlahov equal to the task. Posting up O's. Hansen wearing him like a glove. Turn around, out to Williams. Wants to take on Grace, through traffic, left-hand looper. Sapwell will be against him, hand in the back, push on Vlahov.
Well, it worked last time. He figured he'd do another flyer, see if he could get hold of it.
What's he on?
Vlahov made the adjustment. Sapwell really is
selling.
He's on fire.
He's pumped up all right, Rupert.
He's got a couple of fouls now, though.
Yeah, that's
might temper his
them.
Aggression.
Well, it's one of the things that Geelong have to be very careful about, because most of their scoring, as a matter of fact, about 90% of it comes from five people, and he is one of them. So they've got to be careful they don't lose those people, because their bench is not all that strong as far as production. Hanson's first touch of the ball. Able to deflect it off the Geelong player. Pete Hansen has spent his time playing in the Sky West Basketball League for the last couple of years, and very anxious to get back in and play in this Mitsubishi Challenge.
So the Wildcats have possession. 3:47 left in the first quarter, and they lead 16-13. Here's Vlahov trying to back his way to the bucket. Spins on Exum. Maybe get O's. It might be on Exum, in fact.
Now, the question was asked by Ricky Grace as opposed to the goaltending. Referee Lucas said it was still on its way up, but O's just reminded people he can get there. Watch him come up now. He'll come from the weak side to help. Get it out of there.
was close, but he certainly came over far enough, John, to really make sure that there was a lot of doubt in the official's mind.
Andrew Blahoff on the line. Normally shoots at 73% against a team average of 77. The second captain the Wildcats have had.
Gets another shot because someone broke.
Yeah, by virtue of the fact that the defending team has entered across the plane of the line. Of course, that player in question doesn't agree with it.
Do they ever?
No. And he's done it again. He's done it again. This is just to confirm. Of course, the real pressure goes on Andrew Blahoff now.
He just wanted to prove that they were making a mistake.
Of course, Michael Butler, referee Michael Butler, who's called that, was in Atlanta, John.
He was. Michael Butler was selected to referee during the Olympics. Andrew Blahoff has made it. Must have had a second thought about the sub, Michael.
Well, Vanderputten, I think, was quite happy that he had that third shot. Didn't look like he was going to get in.
So Gavin Vanderputten comes into the game.
Putting some fresh bodies out there. A little bit of extended defense out here off the trap. A 1-2-2 trap. Looking to get O's. O's finds Sapple for the little jump hook. O's with a big offensive board and the putback. Got to block him out. He averages 13 rebounds a game.
Margin is 3 points in favour of the home team, the Wildcats, who have lost, as you saw earlier in the opener, lost three of their last five on both sides of the Olympic break. And that is not causing Adrian Hurley too many smiles.
Well, Cecil Exum comes up with the ball. There's a real veteran. Played with Melbourne, played with North Melbourne, now with Geelong.
There's Sapwell. Exum tries to get past Vanderputten and does, and gets the two and will go to the line.
It's the bonus, and that's really what you're talking about when you're talking the veteran against the rookie. Vanderputten, first year in the league. Exum with a pump fake, made the contact, stepped around, makes the bucket, becomes a three-point play.
He's pretty tough when he gets in there, John. He's got some good moves, good strong moves, uses his body very, very well.
He's scored over 2,000 points in the Mitsubishi Challenge, Mike, so he's no stranger in finding what he has to do to score. Trahair wearing a knee bandage for the first time that I can remember. A little tweak there during practice that stood out a couple of days. Been that sort of week of practice for the Wildcats, Mike.
Oh, here we go. Lichty's taking it strong. Exum's come over and helped. Actually, I think there was three of them. Sapwell, Curl and Exum. They don't want to give Todd too much in here, do they?
No, he's explosive. And Michael, the thing that people have started to realise about Todd Lichty, he's almost ambidextrous. He can go either way, left as good as the right, and that gives a tremendous advantage on the offense. Lichty good from the line. 17 plays, 19. 3-point lead for the home club. Now 20 plays, 17. Extended. That's a 1-2-1-1 by the look of it. Not going to matter to O's. O's is just going to throw it down. Too much space at the back.
And that reduces the gap to one. Approaching 2 minutes left in the first quarter. And Ray O's has 4 points. But Sapwell leads the scoring for Geelong. Here is Stewart once again open.
Anthony Stewart, 2 from 2, both from beyond the three-point arc.
At six.
Well-executed play, that one. Stewart had plenty of time to just line it up, as does this man right here.
Good blocking out by Lichty. Here's Trahair. He has been in some good form this year. That pass not so flash, but well done, Stewart. Grew 6 inches to get that. Here's Lichty posting up through traffic. Give to Vanderputten.
Very nice little play, that one.
Well, nice little dish there from Lichty, and having watched him train since March, everybody looks at his offensive skills, his scoring, his driving. The thing that I've learned to appreciate is his passing skills. He passes very, very well. Creates and passes, and he's got that NBA flair. When he passes, he really nails the man. Finds him. No mistake, you've got to catch his passes.
So, the gap is all of a sudden out to six. 1:30 left in the quarter. O's.
Tom Raines.
Three.
Oh, he can do it all.
He can, and Ray has seven. Geelong have 22.
Makes it a little tough when the big guy steps out of the three-point line.
Hard to make the adjustment, Michael, if you're trying to keep him off the boards.
You've got to cover him everywhere, don't you?
Yeah.
Hansen. Here's Grace. Wants left side. Little give to Vanderputten. Good hand, Exum. Well done, Vanderputten. Got to protect the basketball. This time he says, I'll go on my own. Step Why around not? The defence. Hits off the glass. Exum gets in, gets the rebound. Probably could have been a foul against Vanderputten. Not called. Here's Grace. Loose ball.
Stewart needs to make it, doesn't he?
And he does. Nice drive by Stewie. Just had a look, gave the defence a little head and shoulders, and hey, if you've just nailed two in a row from outside, they're going to go for the fake. Took it strong to the basket.
This crowd here at the Perth Entertainment Centre is jammed in, and unlike a game against Geelong, but they've been starved a bit, haven't they, John?
Yes, they have been starved of action here. Here's Scalzi from Raines too, and he can generally make those, and there's a little fortuitous putback there with a finger roll from Exum, and there's nothing in it. They're expecting a good game here at the Entertainment Centre, and they're getting it. 24 plays, 27. We're in the last play phase of the quarter.
So that might have been Grace, actually, that knocked that back in. Come on.
He won't admit to it.
Exum got his hand there. Unfortunately, Vanderputten went to help out, and Exum snuck in the back.
Okay.
Oh, there's Vanderputten. Just about lost the handle on it. They've thrown it across to you, Tim. You've denied the pass. They're back into play now.
Well, we've got 5.5 seconds left to go in the quarter. Ian Stacker is ropeable at the call by referee Cliff Brett. There he is there. Takes a lot to ruffle his feathers too. Grace. Here's Trehair. 3 seconds. Round the defence. Pull up. Doesn't go. So the quarter time score here at the Perth Entertainment Centre. Perth Wildcats 27, Supercats 24.
When you're striking out, it's time to get some help.
We'll find your girl, no worries.
She said she liked him.
Is she all right? You really are a great girl.
Could he be onto a sure thing?
Tonight's going to be my night.
While covering for a friend can lead to trouble.
I told you to hit fast because mine, and that should be the end of it.
But things are about to get worse.
I don't think that name is unnecessary. He'll expel me, Mal.
And Steve's out to impress.
You always manage to look so perfect. Am I interrupting something?
It's a relationship in trouble.
I do love you.
Neighbours, 6:30 weeknights.
With side intrusion bars built into every Pajero, you can rest assured the great outdoors stays outdoors. Please consider.
Now enjoy Chicken Treat's new chicken and pasta Neapolitana with a free Coke for only $4.50. That's our best penne pasta Neapolitana. A quarter barbecue chicken plus Coke for only $4.50 at Chicken Treat now.
BMW drivers expect their tyres to let them safely use every drop of the exhilarating performance that has been engineered into their car. That's why BMW owners internationally are changing to Maxxis.
Maxxis, exclusively available from Ian Diffen World of Tyres and Mufflers.
Widespread panic has gripped the countryside.
Independence Day.
From the legendary Notre Dame comes the new, fully animated Secret of the Hunchback.
There must be something more than
nearly 1 hour of total family entertainment. The story of a lifetime, and it's yours to own forever. And with every copy of the video, you'll receive absolutely free the soundtrack cassette. The Secret of the Hunchback, out now, $19.95 from CEL.
That's the scoreline, 27-24 at the Entertainment Centre. A tough opening for the Perth Wildcats. Leading scorers for that team, Anthony Stewart has 8, came in off the bench. Vlahov has 6, Trehair 5, Sapwell has 8 for Geelong, and Oz has 7 for the Supercats. And, well, John, we expected it to be tight early in Geelong as Grace gets in off the tip. We expect it to be tight, and it has been.
That's exactly what it is. And of course, what that does point out to me, Tim, is the absolute competitive nature of the Mitsubishi Challenge. Here's a team in 12th position. They're really taking it to one of the favourites.
Well, this Geelong team, gentlemen, is a far better Geelong team than the one the Wildcats played early in the season. They really have come together well. They brought Orlando Williams in, who gives them some real danger from outside, which means the defence has to be extended, opening it up for guys like Oz inside.
Sue Selexon is on the line. He has 4 points. He has been around, as you said earlier, John. He just keeps battling away.
He's a true professional. Good, solid body, works hard, as a lot of players do, has tended to leave the paint, the war zone, as he's got a little older. Floats a little bit further from the bucket these days to Cecil.
Rupert Sapwell sitting on the bench with extended defence on the Wildcats. Against the Wildcats, that was an ambitious pass from Trehair. Williams has Skelzy. Well done, Trehair. Well done. Slap back by Grace, but it comes to Geelong. Williams open. It's a looper. Doesn't go. And Lichty got back to pull in the big board. They're running the court, the Wildcats.
I suspect that Lichty's going to see a lot of action here tonight, Michael.
I think you're right. There's some nice moves being made by all the players out on the floor at the moment. Just finishing off a nice pass from Trehair was Vlahov inside.
Oz gets rid of Crawford. Well done, Trehair. Got the body in the way. Grace will get onto the loose ball and does. The Wildcats. Numbers favour Geelong in defence, though. Looping past Trehair. Spots up. In, out. Lichty's there.
Good move. Knew just how long he had. Only has 3 seconds in the keyway. Fake to the right, fake to the left.
And about 2 seconds in the air as well, I think, John.
A little bit of hang time, as they say in the classics, Michael.
Lads, can I get your reaction to Lichty? The exposure that Todd Lichty has had in the, say, 2 weeks has been enormous. It is a fresh face for the Wildcats. Do you agree?
No, there's no doubt about that. And
just adds a little bit extra to the team?
Well, it does. And the Wildcats really have some players that have always concerned, or been concerned, I should say, in an Olympic year, and a lot of wear and tear. And we do unfortunately see that with what's his name over there, the guy with the bad ankle, Scott the Fisher.
Oh, Fisher, that
one. That's
Fisher
the one.
Yeah, that's the one.
But he,
his knee's not too fresh either.
No, I know. And ultimately, the Wildcats were concerned. Now, with Lichty, of course, you've got a proven player. With Hansen, you've got a proven player. And all of a sudden, they run to 8 and 9 without any trouble.
And Mike explained to the viewers that Lichty has been around the Wildcats camp for some time.
Well, he's been here basically from the start of the season, probably about 3 or 4 weeks in. He came over on a holiday to visit his good friend Andrew Vlahov and has been training with the Wildcats. And the thing that was impressive about him was, as you see, geez, that's a long way out. He was not someone that is a very flash, you know, overbearing player. He's a real team-orientated sort of player.
And of course, Tim, the reason that the Wildcats have been able to bring both Lichting and Hansen back in is that Scott Fisher and Ricky Grace have stood out the period of 3 years as an Australian citizen, and they are now regarded as unrestricted players, which is the international ruling.
A standoff curl and his shot short. It hasn't got the radar on. Fast break, Lichty, Crawford to his left. Oops, went for the crossover and missed it completely, and Curl comes up with it. That's an ambitious and poor pass. Here's Trehair, Lichty, give to Crawford, do something with it.
Well, they really didn't do it well then. They had plenty of space, plenty of timing, but their rhythm wasn't out. They were all too close. They were trying to avoid the contact. Great steal by Trehair. You can see they're all just a little bit too close to each other. Shoveled the pass. A little bit fortunate that Sapple's come across with a foul.
All running into each other there, yeah. John. Let's all run down this one lane on the floor, shall we? What?
The old herd mentality, Michael.
No, it was like the one defensive player could have covered all five of them at one time.
You can see in that graphic, folks, in 105 games for Geelong, starting his career in 1982, actually making his debut against the Perth Wildcats here in Perth, he became their greatest scorer and greatest rebounder ever.
And he had a good start in that game too, I might add, John. He was fairly impressive in that one.
He was, and my memory tells me, Mike, and I watched you play in that, that everybody thought he was on half a leg. He certainly conned everybody.
Well, that's for sure.
Margin is out to 9 points in this game at the Perth Entertainment Centre in front of a packed house. Rose hit the deck. Here's Trehair from the pass from Lichty. Bounce pass, posting up Vlahov. He's class, and he has 12 points to the big game high.
Nice, strong move out there by the Wildcats, and a good pass from Trehair. Of course, just to round that story off, I know we're looking there at Ian Stacker as we watch the replay now, because James Crawford has a big effect on both these clubs, Mike, because he's also the leading scorer and rebounder for the Perth Wildcats all time.
Time out here at the Perth Entertainment Centre. It's a double digit lead to Perth. They lead 36-25.
You want excitement?
Tonight, the good times start with The Simpsons.
Life is like a box of chocolates.
A brand new episode.
I don't have to listen to these wild allegations.
Doofus.
And if you haven't met Jeff Foxworthy, you're in for a rude shock.
Hello, these are my panties.
Those may be the five most beautiful words ever spoken.
It's a comedy double causing too much trouble.
That boy's parents must have made some terrible mistakes.
Shut up, Mom!
6:30 tonight, an all-new Simpsons followed by The Jeff Foxworthy Show.
Can you see? Can you see it's new?
It's you. It's new.
Please consider the new Mitsubishi Lancer sedan.
If you're looking for some great Father's Day gift ideas, then check Marlowe's 10-page Father's Day sale catalogue in the Sunday Times TV Extra magazine. There's great motoring bargains like these 40-piece tool kits at just $16.95. Or what about a 1,400-kilogram trolley jack at a bargain price of $33? And 5 litres of Castrol GTX2 engine oil is just $15.50. But look, there's heaps of other specials, plus the chance to win a brand new Daihatsu Charade with selected Castrol purchases. So get your Marlowe's Father's Day sale catalogue in the TV Extra magazine.
It's the left-wing tire lobby!
The public deserve freedom of choice and a range bigger than a rifle range.
Rifle?
Kraft Acor's wall and floor tile prices are the best. It's automatic.
Automatic?
Vault into Kraft Acor now and target our huge tile range at low tile prices.
I'll call the police commissioner.
You mean the royal commissioner? The public are free to choose any Kraft Acor store.
Don't you mean Kraft Acor?
Fremantle, Joondalup, Cannington, Wimbley, Homebase and Midland.
Hey folks, it's our winter stock take sale, and there's a huge saving on all our curtains. See our large range of ready-to-hang curtains in many sizes and many colours, and our prices start from just $25 per width and continuous pinch peel balance from $25 per metre. And see our great range of continuous terralling from just $5.99 per metre, and the all-new ready-to-hang pelmet in many different fabrics from just $99. And only at Tony Sadler's Homebase Wembley, Balcatta Junction, Booragoon, Rockingham and the Cannibal Clearance House.
So, what are you having for dinner?
Well, it's my turn to cook. We've got some steaks at home. Pepper steak. It's easy with Maggi pepper sauce. You just add boiling water. It's smooth and rich. You can taste the real pepper. Mmm. Looks delicious. It makes our meal a little more special. She'll love it.
What will I love? Another delicious idea from Maggi.
Geelong has only added 1 point since quarter time. Worrying signs, I would think, John Gardner.
Well, I think this is the real time for the Wildcats. They need to ram home this advantage. And, of course, you're right, Geelong would be concerned. Stacker spent a long time there trying to get their mind back on the job.
Well, he was obviously concerned with their defence, because the Wildcats are getting down, getting good ball reversal on the break, getting the ball inside, like you end up with Curl stuck on Vlahov, which is a no-win situation for Geelong. And he wants them to work out and getting back quickly.
Well, gee, they've done a good job on O's. They're doubling down most times and they're making it tough. That's got to be close, but it's a non-call and the advantage is left for the Wildcats. Oh! We will give him the benefit of the doubt and suggest that the foul stopped the dunk.
Will we?
No, we won't.
I didn't think so, Mike. You were pretty close. You think he should have just taken the conventional way.
No, I think he took off a tad too far out is what he did.
That's not bad from two guys that have never dunked the ball ever.
I take exception to that rule.
It would be exception.
When you played, the basket wasn't so high.
Yeah, but we had little trampolines set in on the baseline there. You forgot about those.
Anyway, he made the first from the line, Todd Licton. He's just slowly building on these points, and he now has 7. Blahov is the game high scorer at 12, and hasn't he crept up, Blahov? We've been talking about O's and Sapwell and...
Yeah, he's been on the end of some very nice Trehair passes and just finished them off very nonchalantly inside, nice close-range stuff.
Yeah, I think that's one of the advantages, Tim, when you look at the bringing in these two players at this stage. We've got a situation where... Coach Hurley is able to take some minutes off the starters, and they should be quality minutes that are paid back with the fresher legs and people like Blahov. They should be the recipient of that particular situation. So it'll be interesting to see if it does pan out that way. And of course, we've got a worrying trend already, haven't we, for Geelong? What's the foul count, Tim? Something like about 8-4.
8-4.
And so that's a problem, because Geelong lead the league, averaging 25 personal fouls per game, and that's a bad sign for them already.
Here is O's. Exum posting up, trying to get past Rob. Can't do. Well done for Head. Double team. And the ball spills out. So a good help defence by the Wildcats.
Little double down there, making it very difficult for Exum. At the other end, you really see how valuable that was. Not even an attempt from Geelong. The other end to score, and all of a sudden the scoreline says 41-25 in favour of the Wildcats.
John, I think a good lesson there for most people. The way Trehair filled that lane, got down nice and deep in the corner. The ball got led up and bang, in for a three.
Well, there was some scream you may have heard from the Geelong bench claiming basket interference, goaltending, whatever you want to call it, and the bucket should have counted. It didn't matter. Geelong were able to put it back in. Gee, we've got a couple of big bodies on the floor now as Andrew Svaldinas comes on. I suspect he may well be matched up with Pete Hansen. Not a place in the keyway for the faint-hearted.
Not for me, thanks. I'll stay out here. They open up for Grace. Little pass to Hansen, and Hansen has his first points for the night. And there is already a very good spread of scoring for the Wildcats, Mike and John.
Which is what they want. I think statistically they are able to put about 7 or 8 people in double figures, and that's certainly a very, very tough assignment to answer.
That makes life easier, Tim, for defences when the Wildcats can shut down probably 2 of the Geelong players.
Oh, look at Lichty though. He got in. He was out of position after the miss layup by Blahov. Grace picks up the dregs, gets it out to Trehair. Grace in the corner, he wants the ball foul on Curl.
This is the danger now, of course, for Geelong. The Supercats have to be very careful they don't get disheartened. You've got a feel for Stacker. Needs to regroup these people. Make sure they keep the hands out of there. Hand fouls will kill you. The referees will tolerate, rightfully so, the body contact, but you will get pinged for the hands. Geelong have gone to a zone, little 2-1-2 zone, maybe a 2-3, now looks like a 2-1-2. Grace pumps, goes off the window, unsuccessful. O's almost had it. Hansen put it up just for the service line.
Here's Williams, pulls up over the top of Trehair, doesn't go, and there was a push against Grace.
Yeah, gee, Williams is fairly predictable. He comes down and doesn't hesitate with that left-handed pump and then the shot.
No, he's not shy at all. He looks like he's having a bit of a struggle tripping over that three-point line right at this point in time. He needs to maybe take it at them. But I suppose the thing he's looking at is that the Wildcats' defence is swarming very well, and they're cutting off that drive as well. So,
yeah, it's a tough one out there, but I think he does need to penetrate. Svaldinas complains, all to no avail. Lichty long to Trehair, look away to Hansen, off the window, not so good, gets it back. No, they don't come up with possession. 43 plays, 27, almost halfway in the second quarter.
Subs from both teams. Aaron Trehair sits down. Anthony Stewart checks in. And Stewart has been nice and constructive. Hasn't missed yet. 8 points, 3 of 3 from the field, including 2 of 2 from the arc.
Put a fair amount of pressure on his next shot, Timmy.
Yeah, just call him Mr. Efficient, shall we?
Wildcats going to a 2-3 zone. Looking to come down, working the axes, getting out to the corner and the short corner. They relay it across. Licky's hand is there. Curl, trying to pump into Svaldinas. He looks to penetrate. Scalzi, good from distance, comes up short. Lichty with a good rebound.
They really haven't shot very well at all, John, have they? I don't know, they haven't got the percentages there, but it must be pretty average.
38%, Michael, which is about what the Wildcats shot in the Magic game last week when they went down. So that's not a good percentage. The Wildcats, 10 percentage points ahead of that at 48. The other thing, of course, Tim, is that the Geelong Supercats have only managed, they've got out there 32 shots, so that's not too bad, 12 from 32, but their shots, conversion rate is not good.
Has Sapwell got a few fouls there? Again,
he's got three, sitting down
okay,
with
that's
three.
Fair enough.
Curl put back by Ray Owes, and Ray now has 7 points.
Has been their best offense in the last couple of play phases. Get it off the backboard and let Owes try and put it back. 29 plays 43. Ricky Grace with a little floater. Not so good. Owes with another board.
43-29. The margin is 14. Got out to 16. Here's almost a travel by Curl.
Albina back to Curl. She's just got the feet down there. You're right, Tim. There's another one from Scalzi. That'll be a hand foul on Spaldinas. That is the foul that will send them to the bonus, of course. And Spaldinas comes up with his first.
Ian Stacker has a chance to talk to his troops because we have a timeout at the Perth Entertainment Centre. There's worrying times for Geelong. They trail 29-43. Game high score so far, Vlahov has 12 and Ray Owes has 9 for the Geelong Supercats. Anything on the stat sheet, John, that impresses you?
Well, I don't know. You look for reasons and you find that Stewart with 8, we've made mention of how well he has played and scored. Vlahov, he has also really come up there at 56% for his 12. Crawford started well early, has gone a little quiet. Ricky Grace has not scored. That's a worrying sign for Ricky because last week against the Magic, Ricky shot at 27% for his 10 points and he looks a little bit out of sorts to me. He's carrying the ball well. Doesn't have, he has 4 assists and 4 rebounds. That's very good. But if you look at the Geelong club at 37%, they are also struggling on the boards. They're being out-rebounded 18-14. They have 10 fouls to 4. And the assist situation, I think, tells a great story. The Wildcats have passed the ball around with 10 assists. Geelong have only 3, and that's always a bad sign.
Doherty,
one of the younger players, stepping up whenever he can in this circumstance. And if you look at the background there, Scott Fisher would love to be on the floor. Wildcats with a very good lead at the moment, 14 points up, 5 to go. Be interesting to see, Tim, if they come out and really come at the team. I think they should, and of course all the pressure must be on this club as they come back out.
Ricky Grace hasn't scored, but he's got 4 assists and Trehair has 3.
I thought he would have had more the way he was dishing the ball. I suppose they missed a couple, but just listening to Mr. Stacker down that end there, he was very encouraging of his players. He's saying, look, in the vast majority of cases, you're taking good shots. They're just not going down. He said, you've got to keep shooting the ball with confidence and just keep working hard. You know, he wants Curl and Scalzi to look a little more for the three-point shot, so be aware of that. And defensively, he said, we've just got to put all sorts of pressure on them and stop their break.
Pete Hansen, unsuccessful with the first, makes the second. Not renowned for being a great foul shooter, Pete Hansen.
It's not what you normally say, John. You normally give him a far bigger bagging than that.
Well, that's what I'm normally coaching him, Michael.
Of course, for our viewers, John Gardner coaches the Perry Lake Hawks in the SkyWest SBL. Scalzi.
That's a fairly impressive move from the young man, Matt Scalzi. Played about 8 games with Adelaide last year before transferring to Geelong. He's got a future.
He's got some big hops too. He's quite a skinny little fella, but gee, he can get up.
Ricky is on the score sheet with a big three from the corner. There's Virtue. That will be a charge, one would think. Offensive foul as Anthony Stewart picks himself up off the deck.
Did you get the number of that truck, says Stewie?
Oh, poor old Stewie, Mike. He's had that sort of year, hasn't he? You know, he hurt that wrist early. Defensively put his body on the line and he got a hip bump over there.
But then what happens, John? Of course, he's hurt the wrist and he takes all these charges and falls back on it again just when it starts to get better.
So I have to have a couple of drills to get him to fall on the left wrist.
Through traffic, float up.
Whoa, he's there again.
A fact, that was a little floater.
It was a little floater, Tim, and he did it well.
Little leaner. The margin is 18 points.
Healthy margin to the Wildcats. That really is very obvious. One wonders what the Geelong club can do at this point. They seem to be struggling for answers as Leonard comes on the floor for the first time in his second game in the Mitsubishi Challenge. Ose backs Hansen in, and lo and behold, he finds the big hand of Van der Putten. Grace gets the benefit of the steal, and the shot comes up from Stewie, and he's missed the first.
Geelong, here's Leonard. First time I've seen him in action. You can shoot if you like. So he does. He steps inside the arc.
He was always going to miss that one, wasn't he?
He really thought long and hard about it, Mike. He thought 18 down. I don't suppose they're really going to make it tough on me if I take a three. Well, I guess that's the problem, that they're struggling to find some sort of offensive action out there. The Wildcats have conceded 9 to O's, and that's very respectable. Williams, right-hand dribble, pulls up, finds Faldinas, shoulder to shoulder with Hansen, foul and the point.
Pete, not a bad job, just a little late on that rotation, John. I think he could have been there probably one or two steps earlier and could have cut that drive off by Scalzi.
Well, plenty of time, Mike, wasn't there? Plenty of time to read it on that pick and roll play as Lichty sits down with 7 points and 7 rebounds.
Yes, and Phil Doherty sees some early court time in this first half. The only player so not to get on the court so far for the Wildcats is Ryan Gardner. And I did notice as I walked into the entertainment centre, a big sign in green letters that had Gardner. It's up about the first flight past the Wildcats bench. It says Gardner, Gardner, Gardner. And I meant there's Ryan there, but apparently it's for you, John.
Is that right? Goodness me.
I was here earlier, Tim. John was actually putting it up.
Oh, dear. I thought the paint would have been dry by now.
Yes, but anyway, good to see the Gardner family here tonight.
Ricky Grace looking to find Doherty. Geelong settling back now in this zone, trying to stem the flow. Problem really has been poor offensive selection as Ricky Grace comes up with one from the glass.
He heard you. He's got 5.
He did. He needs that. His confidence has been down. His judgments haven't been great. Seems to be a little out of sorts, as I said earlier, but he's too good a player to stay there for long.
Exum gets past, but then gets what's 5 teams, whatever that is. Anyway, they stand off everyone, and Williams is there. Ooh. Williams did well. Stewart put his body on the line. Little shake and bake there by Williams.
Not much of Williams, is there? And he plays. He doesn't necessarily play in the point. Looks like in the two-guard situation, he's definitely a shooter. He likes to throw the rock up.
He's got big pectorals because he's a big fella for a little bloke, if you know what I mean.
He's chesting everybody up.
Yeah. Here's Exum. Scalzi. Well done, Doherty.
Oh, he's triple teamed.
Leonard. Ose crashes the boards, put a hand in by Van der Putten. Do the numbers favour Perth? They do. Doherty. Finger roll. Doesn't go. Well done, Ray Ose.
See, they're coming down in numbers, and Geelong don't have a lot of answers for it. They just need to be able to convert some of those.
Timeout. Wildcats 51, Geelong Supercats 34. The margin is 17 points. 2 minutes left to go in the second quarter, which means the half.
They've been comfortable, haven't they, on that 17-18 point margin for so long now. Makes it hard for Geelong to come back in with only 2 to go. But they have shown some promise. They really are struggling, though, to find the answers. Still shooting at 38%. Wildcats at 47. You can see Ricky Grace coming down the middle. Ricky Grace has 5 points. And for the Wildcats, Vlahov still has 12. Stewart, 10. He's done very well. If we go to the Geelong Supercats, Faldinas has 3. Scalzi, 4. Sapwell, 8. Ose, 9. Exum, 7. 17 rebounds for the visitors, 20 for the home club. I guess the rest of it's fairly clear. We go to the foul line out there. 71%, 10 from 14 for the Wildcats, 2 from 4. Gee, that's not a lot of foul shots to take. I guess that's indicative of their lack of endeavour in getting the ball inside, which is an area that the Wildcats do patrol very well. They like to go inside and then go to the foul line.
Ricky Grace, 5 points, 4 assists and 4 boards, 3 steals. So Well, the scoring might be a worry. He's still had a fair night, hasn't he?
Oh, yeah. He just needs the points now. He just needs the points to build it up. Mind you, that we talked earlier about the extra options the Wildcats now have, and that sometimes relieves a point guard of taking those shots and can play the real general's role out there.
Here's Leonard. Screen set by Exum. In the corner is Ray Owes. Inside 2 minutes left to go in the half. Orlando Williams gets via Grace. Little dish to Exum. He just goes through. Hand in Vlahov. Helped by Doherty.
Kim come against the zone now. They probably will go inside first before they dish it. Second time they get it, they're looking for it. That's what Stewart's done. Little unsuccessful. Plenty of competition there from Crawford. He called it too. He was pretty sure of the call, Mike.
He got it right, that's for sure. He actually bumped Scalzi, and Scalzi coughed it up out of court.
A little out of bounds play. It'll go long out to Stewart. Full shot clock. Plenty of time to play with. Minute 20 on the game clock.
Baseline Crawford. Well done, Scalzi. Oop, bounce up. Grace has to get back on it. Leonard is very quick travel.
He did travel, there was no doubt. He picked the ball up and took the step. He travelled.
Me?
I think he was actually waiting for that cross-court call.
I thought
realised he didn't get it and then tried to dribble it.
Yeah, he looked a bit tentative, Mike. I know he's had a bit of trouble with his instep and a couple of those problems with the foot, and he didn't go for travel, it was a trip.
I was going to say. Took four lazy steps. Here is Williams. Pull up. Doesn't mind a shot. There you go, two.
He likes to take a shot, and of course he's so left-handed with that shot. You would think the Wildcats will make the adjustment.
The big O, they call him. Bounce pass to Vlahov, back to Stewart. That might be travel too.
Yeah. Degenerating here. The coaching staff will not be happy. They need to get the ball inside. I mean, this is where coaches get so anxious. 14, 15 points is not a lot of lead. It can be gobbled up. Mind you, the way that Geelong are playing, you wouldn't see that happening right now. It only takes a couple of buckets, like there's that man again.
Catch and shoot by Williams. Crawford there, put back. Scalzi doesn't go, but he'll draw the foul and go to the line.
You really do need to get O's blocked out further from the basket, John. He's just got such a good leap and long arms. He can go over your back, keep the ball alive, and that's exactly what he did that time. Scalzi's picked it up and got the bonus, or got the foul by going down to the foul line. I mean, you know, you just got to get him out further.
Well, particularly with the lineup they have, Michael. Scalzi is tall. He's not very solid. You've really got to do the job on O's first. You've got to take the main man out of there and then rely upon your partners to help. You can't ignore a man that leads the Mitsubishi Challenge with 13 rebounds per game.
So inside the final 30 seconds.
A little extended defense. This is an interesting sort of a deal at this point. It's working at this game, and we've got a timeout called by Ricky Grace. And that's a very strategic call by Grace, not the one that the coach wanted, but he was close to a 10-second tie-up. The shot clock was down to 22. Not that is the ruling factor. The referees count the 10, but he also had a 5-second tie-up with pressure on the ball, so he's taken the way out and called a timeout.
Margin got out to 18. It's now sort of been whittled back to 14.
And they should have one more possession, Tim, before half-time. I guess this does give the coach a time to set the offense up. He'd be a bit concerned that they've had two turnovers where they really didn't get to take a shot. If you look at the field shooting percentage, the Wildcats have gone off the boil just a little bit. You know, down to 45, they're up to 48, which is their season's average. And of course, if you look at Ian Stacker, there's not a lot he can do about the 37%. He'd love to get the Geelong Supercats up to 45, which is their season's average. From the three-point line, it has been a better story for the Wildcats. If you look at them at 56%, that's very respectable. 5 from 9, but 2 from 18 from the Geelong Supercats. They will live or die from range.
And Orlando Williams has 1 of 7 from out there, and he has got 5 points. Orlando loves white grapes.
Is that right?
Yes,
Timmy,
he does.
Timmy, where have you grabbed that from?
I saw him walk in with a bunch of grapes.
Goodness gracious me.
And they were white, Mike Ellis.
They weren't in a bottle.
Were they lady fingers?
What did you decipher from that timeout, Con the Fruiterer?
Well, basically, what's going to happen is I think you'll find the Wildcats obviously will take the last shot, but more importantly, they will take it with very little time left on the clock. Hurley does not want the Geelong team to get a last shot at this before half time.
No, he wants 2 points. If nothing else, he needs to get the team in the room to talk to them with the scoreline as it is.
Let's count it down. 10 seconds left. Stewart, baseline Grace. Give to Linky, put it on the deck, left hand doesn't go. The pass was right, the offense was right, but the execution not quite special. Half-time at the Perth Entertainment Centre in the West. The Wildcats 51, Geelong 37.
1 family torn apart by the death of their father.
Sal McCarter battle.
Fighting a war they cannot win. Both caught in a catastrophic rift with the underworld.
Someone is stealing the bodies of the dead.
And the cruel truth lies with the gods.
First sign of evil, you start pointing your finger at gods and monsters.
Now,
it's a trap.
Hercules must tame Gregus, the dog of death.
Obviously, you're not a pet lover.
In an immortal showdown with the undead. It's the ancient world's darkest hour. Hercules, 7:30 tonight.
Can you see? Can you see it's you?
It's you. It's a new you.
Please consider the new Mitsubishi Lancer Coupe.
I'm a complete idiot of myself.
No, you're cute.
I'm John Travolta.
You lie all the time.
Love wins over everything else.
If you're looking for some great Father's Day gift ideas, then check Marlowe's 10-page Father's Day sale catalogue in the Sunday Times TV Extra magazine. There's great motoring bargains like these French knit car seat covers at just $23.50 a pair. Or what about a 275 PSI air compressor for only $129? And this stereo car radio cassette is just $29.95. But look, there's heaps of other specials, plus a chance to win a weekend holiday for two at the Broadwater Resort in Busselton. The entry form's in Marlowe's Father's Day sale catalogue in the TV Extra magazine.
Ladies, meet your very own Western Reds, rugby league's finest, back home at the Wacker Saturday night for a special ladies' night. Get to your participating Schwarzkopf PH Club salon and receive a voucher for you and a friend to attend the big game. Free with every cut and blow wave. The special seating, great entertainment, prizes and giveaways. Even passes to Orsini's at the Sheraton after the game. This is the place to be Saturday night. Tickets on sale now at all Red ticket outlets. Now ladies, that's worth checking out.
14 points the margin here at the Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats 51, Geelong 37. It's all ahead of Geelong, John Gardner.
Yes, you wonder what they have to do to turn these stats around. The Wildcats shooting at 43%. They are 18 from 41, up against 16 from 43 at 37 for the Supercats. The foul shooting certainly favours the home club at 71%, but the big imbalance there is the number taken. 14 by the Wildcats, 6 by the Supercats from the range. 55%, extremely respectable from the Wildcats, not so good at 11% from the visitors. Rebounding, fairly even as you would expect. Assist favouring the Wildcats because they do tend to share it around. Turnovers respectable, and the fouls, they've tended to even out. 11 for Geelong against 7 for the Wildcats. Look at the top scorers out there. Vlahov with 12, Stewart who's shot so well, Trehear 8, Lichty started well, faded a little bit with 7, Grace has built upon his early start for 5, O's, Big Ray O's out there with 9, Sapwell 8, Exum 7, Scalzi 5, Williams has taken a lot of shots and he's only got 5 points to show for it.
Mike Ellis, it would be a concern for Geelong, no one in double figures to half time.
Well, absolutely. You know, they've got to find some scorers from somewhere. They are struggling and, they need Rose and in particular Curl and Williams to step up for them.
There is Trehear. Grace, well done. Oh, he's got a hand above the ring to clean it out of there.
Ricky Grace with the left-hander. usually so reliable. Very important 5-minute period here for both clubs. Wildcats need to build. Geelong need just that sort of start. A little sneaky layup on the right-hand side. Simon Curl, first points for the game.
Yeah, 1 of 8 at 12%. Simon Curl, he's a streak shooter. Gets the hot hand, he's hard to stop. Here's Grace and Trehear. In the corner was Lichty. Posting up Vlahov on O's. Turnaround. Easy. Down 14.
A lot of attention there from Ray O's, but Vlahov was just too strong for Ray O's. He's a very good athlete, but he hasn't got the strength of an Andrew Vlahov. Particularly in that low post is your situation. Down in the war zone. Jeez, he likes a shot, and why not? That's a good one, but his percentage is not so good. Williams out there is 3 from 11.
He'll figure if you keep shooting it, your percentage has got to get better. You only have to make a couple.
Sure, he has that shooter's mentality. Don't think about the misses. Think about the ones you're going to make. That's 2 in a row. And it doesn't take long to turn it round. Now we've got a scoreline, which is an 8-point lead to the Wildcats.
So the grape lover has all of a sudden gone from 5 to 11 in the blink of an eye.
He's gone to the top of the cellar. No doubt about that.
Speaking of cellar, he loves it from a long way out. Aaron Trehear knocks down his 11th point with a big tray. He has 3 of 5 from outside.
Big start. Geelong have got the start they wanted. Boy, he's not going to stop now, Michael.
Oh, that's Orlando.
Well, I can tell you now, gentlemen, he has got some range too. He can shoot the ball from a long way out. And the last thing that they want to do, and Grace gives him a quick foul. You can see the breakaway by Curl. But the last thing that they the Wildcats need is for this man to get hot. And already he's very warm.
And we talked about the mentality of a shooter. And they will keep on shooting as he is. He now has 14 points. He's 5 from 13. Now up to 38%. Building upon it. And that was a real rainbow. So the Wildcats have to make sure they send somebody out to him and shut him down. And Ricky Grace has that job.
He was once the Sports Illustrated Player of the Week, Orlando Williams. Scalzi! Crawford blocks his way and I think takes a piece of Scalzi as well.
On the way through, gee, there's a lot of penetration coming against the Wildcats. Geelong are sending it to the baseline. The Wildcats, as a lot of coaches do now, they allow the man to go to the baseline expecting the help to come, but the help must come earlier than that because that's just insurance for the shooter. And the help must come as they double team down low, and it's not quite working for the Wildcats right now. They lead by 8, but Geelong have had all the running in the first 3 minutes. Well, it's not quite 3, it's 2.5 minutes. That 14 point lead has been whittled down by Geelong, and credit to them.
John, in the first half that defense was there. The Wildcats were there the whole time. Nice move, Vlahov inside, dish from Grace. But the defense was strong in the first half. They've come out a little soft to start this second half.
Well, Michael, we watched the first game in Geelong. The home team did just that. They struggled all night and they came out with a big fourth quarter. They did it mostly from the three-point line, which is not happening tonight. But if that man, Williams, has his way, they may well repeat it.
So it's back out to a double-digit lead, 60-49. They got it down to 9 in Geelong. Here's Curl. Scalzi banks in off the glass, doesn't go. Satwell, who started brilliantly, and now Rupert Satwell has finally got into double digits, 5 of 8 with 10 points.
Because he ran into foul trouble. He had that 3 early, and that really didn't help him, as did Lichty there, and Curl has stripped him of the ball. Ozzie, I thought he was going to go for his layup, Mike. He had a second thought about it.
Mate, he had a long look at it, I can tell you right now.
And I think the very fact that there was somebody on his left hand, his shooting hand, just a little closer than what he wanted, made him second guess it.
Scalzi knocks down 2, and all of a sudden the lead is reduced to 7. So Adrian Hurley would be none too pleased with this little stanza of the game.
It's a game of confidence and momentum, and the momentum has swung against the Wildcats. Geelong have picked it up, their confidence is growing, and as they start to relax, they come out and they make the shots that they were missing early.
Vlahov has 18, and he dominates the scoring for the Wildcats. They have 3 in double digits.
Wildcats built their lead on defense. They were able to contain Geelong to 37 points in the first 2 quarters of the game. Already Geelong have blown that out to 53 within about 7 minutes. So they need to get back on track defensively.
Trehear in off the glass for 2, and Aaron Trehear has moved to 13. So Lichty or no Lichty, Trehearne still knocking down some good points.
And he needs to do that. And people such as Trehearne, Stuart Grace, they need to look upon Lichty as a catalyst, not a threat. They need to get out there and take a lead, play their regular game, relax, take the shots. That's the important thing. You see, here's a demonstration of this baseline defense that this time worked. There was no help, no help required that time. Wildcats need to score after that defensive stop.
Lichty's the trailer.
Nobody in the keyway. They need somebody flash cutting to the elbow. Spreading the floor now. Vlahov will get back into the elbow. See the back door from Lichty. The little flare cut from Grace. Trehearne goes underneath. Diving to the short corner. Gets it up. Very dangerous position. If you can get the ball to somebody in that short corner when they dive, you really put the defense at risk. That will send Trehearne to the foul line.
He was certainly going to get that ball up one way or the other, wasn't he?
Timeout here at the Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats 64, the Supercats are 53. The margin at halftime was 14 and it got down to 7. So the Wildcats have steadied John Gardner. Much to, Vlahov and, well, I don't know, who's made him steady? I think Vlahov has.
He's made a couple of big buckets, particularly close to the keyway, where he's made the space they've found in the ball. Trehearne's made a couple as well that were steadiers. But more importantly, they've now regrouped. They are able to put the pressure back on Geelong and hence the timeout. Stacker saw his club come out, do all that he wanted, get back in the ball game, down to 7. Chance to come back even further and really make it a contest. They lost a little bit of the handle on their offense and their choices weren't all that good. Those choices gave the Wildcats the ball. Bingo.
Orlando Williams just came out and look at that. That's a rainbow.
Yeah, check it for ice. It was a long way in the air, but you know, they've made a mistake with Williams, of course, haven't they? He's got 14 now, but what they didn't do is keep on that left hand.
He just catches and shoots.
He's certainly not penetrating as much. Now, Adrian Hurley was showing the concern after those first couple of minutes. He'd be a little more comfortable now, but it's the great thing about this league, Tim. You cannot take anybody for granted. I mean, you look at Ricky Grace in there dishing to Vlahov. That's an easy bucket. That's a gimme. And that's the sort of penetration that leads to the basket. But more importantly, you cannot write any team off. You've got to be ready to play, not just for a couple of minutes, for the whole game.
They've taken 22 shots from beyond the arc, Geelong, Mike Ellis, and Orlando, who's got Orlando Williams, has got 3 in this quarter alone. It's 4 of 11. So they're not shy to shoot from a long way out.
Well, they can live and die by their shooting out there. In fact, Curl normally launches a number of those rocks up. He's down on his attempts, I think, more than anything. He's had 5 of them, I think. So, he's normally got about 5, 6, probably 9 up by half time. So he's going to be very cold in the arm. He'll be looking to warm that up too, I'd imagine. Defensively, they just... The Wildcats need to do what we were talking about a little earlier, John. You know, really pack it inside, stop that penetration.
Yeah, I mean, Mike, the stat we talked about from the three-point line is something that may not stay there all the time, and you'd rather make them live out there as Williams is doing than get inside, because that's really dangerous territory. So the defense in the keyway in that war zone is very, very important. 53-66.
You've got the book, John.
On what?
The book. I would like to know if this book is heading for a record for three-point shots taken.
Somewhere, Tim, I think you will find somebody's taken more than that. But by the same token, this guy has also got a license to do it. I mean, Stacker knows that he's not getting a lot from the inside, and if Williams makes a couple, he'll just keep on taking them.
But he's on a mission anyway. 4 of 12 so far, 33%. They're 5 of 23 at 22%. The Wildcats are 6 of 10 of 60. Another timeout here at the Entertainment Centre. The margin is back out to 13. The Perth Wildcats are 66. The Supercats are 53.
Don't you just love Fran?
Yeah, don't you love Fran?
Always says what's on her mind.
The stuff that came out of him is more appetizing than that.
Always there to help.
I wouldn't want to obstruct justice.
So catch her for one Frantabulous hour. The Nanny, 6:30 Sunday.
Now enjoy Chicken Treat's new chicken and pasta Neapolitana with a free Coke for only $4.50. That's our best penne pasta Neapolitana. A quarter barbecue chicken plus Coke for only $4.50 at Chicken Treat now.
BMW drivers expect their tyres to let them safely use the exhilarating performance engineered into their car. That's why BMW owners internationally are changing to Maxxis steel radial tyres, exclusively available from Ian Diffen World of Tyres and Mufflers.
You like to move it! I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it! You're nice, sweet, fantastic. Move up on a bit, yes, you move it. Pony woman, you're nice, sweet, fantastic. Reach up on a bit, move a bit, Titanic. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it!
The Mitsubishi Challenge is proudly sponsored by Mitsubishi Motors.
Just when you thought life was a dream,
Griffin,
along comes a demon from the past.
I'm with Justin. I'm really with him.
Just when you thought you had it all,
Sean,
it starts to slip through your fingers.
Sarah loves you.
Right.
Party of Five, 7:30 Sunday.
James Crawford on the line. James only got the 4 points, but started in bold fashion with a huge block, which will certainly be on the weekend show reels, I'm sure, John, but now he's got five. He hasn't missed from the line. He's got a couple of rebounds, but he has found himself in a bit of foul trouble, Mike Ellis. He's got four.
Well, he's out there. That's the trouble. You go up there, you're helping out, trying to block shots and help on the drive, and you're going to pick up a few different fouls. That's all right. James can play with four fouls without a major problem. He knows how to play. He's got lots of experience.
Of course, the other thing that helps that situation is the fact that the Wildcats are deeper with Hanson there, and they've got somebody else that can take over. And he has to maintain, James Crawford, that intensity on O's. They cannot give O's any court.
Trying to colour sways for the defence of Simon Curl, and he's got 4 points.
Yeah, a little runner off the glass there, reminiscent of Vicky Grace. He likes those sort of shots too. Trahear finds Crawford. I thought he was going to jack a three-pointer up, but he found the good passing lane. Little looping cut there from Vlahov with the left-hand bucket.
The big A, the big Andrew Vlahov, has 20 points. The margin is back out to 15. So Vlahov, I would say, is refreshed. Oh, little trip, Curl. I think he tripped over his own feet, to be quite honest.
I think he did. Good defence there from Williams on the defensive transitional situation. Put that turnover down to Williams. He took the transitional defence right up to Trahear. Trahear picked the ball up and there was nobody to pass to.
Yeah, I think Trahear expected Grace to stop for the three-pointer. Ricky thought he wanted him to go to the basket. The old zig and old zag trick.
Curl out on the right-hand wing now, operating against Stewart. Whips it across Galsy. There, you can't leave that guy in space, surely not.
Orlando Williams has connected with his fifth three-pointer, 13 attempts, but he's got 17, had five at half-time.
He will keep on shooting those, there's no doubt about that. Wildcats on their rotation, whilst they need to help, they can't leave Williams through. That was, what, 40 love? Ray O's batting away to Anthony Stewart.
Yes, get that out of here. Here's Vlahov's got 20. Orlando has 17. That's Orlando Williams. First time we've seen him in Perth.
Orlando Williams, he was recruited to replace Joey Wright. Joey Wright, who has played with Geelong for a year or so, had knee problems and was released. Williams was brought in for more points, and that's what he seems to do.
Todd Victy checking back into the game here at the Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats lead by 14, 72. 258, and Lichty's been fairly quiet on the score sheet just with the 7 points, but has got 9 rebounds, so he plays big.
Well, he does a lot of the good things that coaches like, and that's the type of thing that you're looking at. And of course, that man there, he's doing what Coach Stacker wants for Geelong. He's scoring out there, 5 from 13, 38%, very respectable from the three-point arc, and he has 17.
Now, the record for the most number of three-point shots attempted by a Geelong player is Morrison in 1993, made 19 and made 9.
Well, there you go, we might be able to rewrite.
Just thought you'd be interested.
Well, he's going to give it a nudge tonight.
You've just dismissed it like it doesn't mean anything. Here's Vic, need to fade away.
Well, I think it's important to get the message to Williams with a bit of incentive.
I don't think he needs it, John.
Get his name in the book. Here's a little floater, right-handed floater by Curl. It doesn't go.
Good drive. Deserved a better fate there. Penetrated well. Just didn't drop for him.
Crawford running the point for a little while there.
Yeah, I think they've made that adjustment. Now the Geelong Supercats have gone into this 2-3 zone out here. Lichty finds Trahear in the right-hand corner. It hits the back of the rim. Cecil Exum gives it up to Williams. We'll see if he can run the point. He's never run the point. He gives it into O's. O's with a pump fake and the 2-point.
Ray Oates is finally into double figures, had 9 at half time, and his first point since the long break. He's got 11 now, and the margin is back to 12.
Good move. Crawford sits down now. Crawford only has 6 points, has 5 rebounds. It's a 12-point margin. That's how quickly it can evaporate.
It was a quick offense. There's still 22 seconds left on the shot clock.
See if the zone works for Geelong. They need to penetrate. There's nobody inside the paint.
Vanderput running the baseline. Here's Stewart. They double team him. Vlahov through traffic. Banks it in. 22 points for the skipper.
Little one-handed looper off the glass. Andrew Vlahov does look refreshed.
He does, doesn't he?
Yep. Spaldinas comes in. The Terminator.
So, the Wildcats, 74, lead Geelong 60. There is Williams.
So here, giving the job on Williams. Leonard, oh, looking for somebody to pass to, almost lifted the cricket.
Oh, I thought he dragged it anyway. So did Adrian Hurley, coach of the Wildcats. There's Leonard. Tough shot, but does well to get a hand in. Here's Williams. He wasn't too happy because he was inside the arc. Then Ayres licked him. Yep. I won't stop him this time. They can jump the white men. I can't believe Leonard passed that. Yeah. It was like,
dear Todd, I'm about to pass to the point.
Get the highlight reel ready. And he did pick it out. He picked it beautifully. And of course, he runs better downhill, Mike, with that right hand dunk.
Absolutely. Put some pressure on Leonard. Oh, that pass was ambitious. Vlahov almost stole his back turn. O's off the dribble. It's tough. It doesn't go. Lichty now. He bored at the other end. So the Wildcats have a chance to extend this 16-point lead. The trailer is Vlahov. Lichty to the right. Pulls up for two. Todd doesn't go. Vlahov. It's a long ball.
Well, it's a 16-point lead. 1.5 minutes to go as we watch the highlight. Really, he can hop. Keep in mind, folks, he's had both knees reconstructed through the rigors of the NBA, and certainly he's shown us that he's a great athlete.
He's a really, it's a fantastic story, the Todd Lichty story. He's gone through a lot of personal tragedy. He's with the Denver Nuggets. Here's O's off the dribble, doesn't go.
Good defensive board by Vanderput. Looping left-handed pass. They need to move the ball quickly. Vanderput needs to stay close to the glass. Vlahov posting up. It's a long flyer. Lichty just checking the traffic. Comes down. Left-handed pass again. Defense holding. Shot clock down to 7. 7 seconds. It needs to be launched shortly. Somebody needs to make the move. It's going to be Anthony Stewart. Not his preferred option for the shot, but he had to take it.
Oh, now here we go. The question was, gentlemen, was the ball on the rim when the buzzer went?
I don't think
referee
it's going to
make any... Cliffy Brett reckons it wasn't. If the ball's in the air when the 30-second clock goes, then it is deemed to be, well, not so much a violation, but they classify it as a jump ball. If the ball had already hit the ring, then it's play on. If they haven't got the shot up beforehand, then it's the opposition's ball.
Let's check it. Shot goes up. Right now, ooh, it's got to get there quickly. I think it may well have gone to the opposition.
So it should have been a Geelong ball.
I would think so.
I'm absolutely
at that
confused after what Mike Ellis just explained to me, but it's easily done, Mike, I must say.
No prizes for that one, Tim.
Yeah, luck's a fortune, isn't it?
There's Simon Curl, who's had that many haircut designs. In fact, he's had more than I've had hot dinners, to be honest.
I don't believe that.
Yes.
Oh, he's settled down to a nice little rusty colour, too, in the last year or two. He's okay.
Quite a bit of water. I'm sure the water's all right in Geelong. Anyway, here's Lichty. Passed it before, but it was down near his ankles. Didn't get it.
Well, one shot. Will they go for 2-for-1? I think not. Like 2-for-1, often in a close situation, they'll get it down quickly, get the shot up, and hope to get a second run on the next possession or a steal. But they'll wind this down and try and take the last shot of the quarter. Valdez is not necessarily the man to take it. Would imagine Curl, O's. Look to see if they can get them.
Leonard.
Oh, that's a great start.
He's on the score sheet with 3 right on the buzzer. Three-quarter time buzzer, in fact, and Geelong a 63, but they trail the Wildcats 76. The gap is 13 points.
Oh. one of the greatest actors of our time in one of the greatest performances.
You got me all misty eyed.
Al Pacino in his Oscar-winning role with Batman Forever's Chris O'Donnell.
I can't go to New York City.
By Sunday night, you'll be best friends.
The story of an unlikely partnership and an unforgettable journey.
It's a great day for moving along.
For the first time on television.
Would you like to learn to tangle?
Right now.
The sensational box office smash.
Oh, but I still smell her.
Ooh, mama.
Scent of a Woman. 8:30 Sunday on 10.
Hoo-ah!
Can you see? Can you see it's new? Please consider the new Mitsubishi Lancer sedan.
Hi, can I help you?
No, great. Choose the cheese, the choosy cheese.
Choose the chosen cheese?
No. Choose the cheesy lovers that the true cheese lovers... No. Cheesy cheese.
Right now at McDonald's, if you order a triple cheeseburger and can say the triple cheese tongue twister, you'll get a free small Coke and a chance to win AFL Grand Final tickets.
Cheesy cheese.
McDonald's Triple Cheese Challenge. It's really cheesy.
No, that's... Cheesy cheese.
CDs for under 15 bucks. That's gotta be the best price. Choose from a huge range of artists at this unbelievably low price. There's nothing here but the best. Bon Jovi, The Police, John Mellencamp, Van Morrison, Cat Stevens, Lionel Richie, Salt and Pepper, Elton John, Supertramp, Joe Jackson, Suzanne Vega, Kiss. All these great artists and more on CD, available for a limited time for under 15 bucks. That's gotta be the best price.
Melt into a blend of delicious milk and white chocolate with hazelnut praline. Melt into marble. New Cadbury marble.
Entertaining third quarter, but the gap was reduced by just the 1 point for the Geelong Supercats, 76-63. And John Gardner, the Wildcats are travelling along nicely.
Well, I think during the interval, Stacker would have been saying that his club's within striking distance. And as we saw just after half-time, first couple of minutes in this quarter will be equally vital.
Well, the John, the way Williams can fill it up, and we know Curl can fill it up, 13 points is not a lot of points. It really isn't. 76 for the Wildcats is pretty reasonable, but, 63 for Geelong's down, and they can pick that up very rapidly.
Of course, Williams is not starting. There's a bad steal there. O's can't allow this. Can he block it? Ooh. He sent Blahoff sprawling, and we've got a jump ball between Grace and O's.
Good defensive job, John, by O's, I thought, wasn't it?
There's an air of expectancy, precluding from Blahoff. Blahoff was quite prepared to wait. What's the steal? There's the contact. It might have been a bit of forearm as well. Blahoff pushes it out, and... it gets to the jump and Ricky's conceded. Simon Curl with the ball now. Spaldinas comes high, drops low. Well, really, it's up to Curl. If you look at the shooters, Curl or O's, you would have to think have to be the shot takers in this lineup. At the moment, though, Leonard made a big three-pointer right on the bell.
Tough shot by Ray O's. Ray O's now moves to 13 points, 76-65. The gap is 11. Big news from the Sydney Kings versus Hobart Devils game. The Devils won 82-81.
Incredible scoreline. The 10th place, third place team in the Mitsubishi Challenge. And that's the point we were making earlier, Tim. This team, the Geelong Supercats, are the 12th place team in the league, playing the third place team, or fourth, but you can't take any of them easy.
Handy result for Perth, that one, and great result for the Devils, who are fighting for their existence. There's Sapler, pull up for two, and all of a sudden we might have a ball game on our hands here. The end scent, it's 78-67.
Easy as you like from Sapler. The zone seems to be working for Geelong. It's often struggled. Any sort of zone has often troubled the Wildcats. They need to get the ball inside. Need to penetrate, get the ball inside, get it past the first line. That's what Trahair's doing there, and it almost came off. We'll go the other way.
Geelong. So that's, as you say, John, they need to penetrate. Not all the time with a dribble. I'd like to see some bit of high post flashing in there and get some ball passed in there as well. Give it a high-low action happening.
Yeah, exactly right, Michael. I'm with you.
Hope you're enjoying the action around the country. Pass to Spell Dennis. Haven't seen a lot of court time.
He's not confident either, is he? I mean, he's not even looking at the basket.
Had a bad year last year under Calvin. He had Jim Calvin, the coach, that is, and had some injuries. Played with Sydney for a long time, and he's taken a long time to get back into his rhythm, and it's still not there.
He was a big recruit for Adelaide, too, and had troubles with Mike Dunlap. So, his career's sort of on edge a bit, Mike and John, one would think.
Yes, he's been a bit of a journeyman.
Yeah, a little bit of a all-pack-your-bags man.
Very nice man, actually.
He is a nice guy, and he's a fine competitor. I mean, he goes at it, and he plays very, very hard.
Sorry, Mike Crawford almost got the steal of the night. Valdinas has missed the shot and collected Lichty on the cheekbone.
Yeah, and he's bleeding badly. Lichty's taken a lot of skin off that left cheek. He needs to come off.
They'll open him up.
Oh, it's nice too, just I can see it from here. That's a nice little split.
Todd Lichty will sit down and receive treatment. Look at that. That is nasty. Yeah. Didn't like the elbow.
Straight to the locker room. Dr. Tony Galvin will be working the sutures, let me tell you right now.
I'd say a good three or four, Mike.
I haven't had a good look at it, but it's not pretty.
No.
He's not happy either, just quietly.
No, he claims that it was done with a little enthusiasm. I don't think that's the case at all. Valdinas went through, protected the ball. The vigour of the shot made the contact. Unfortunately, Todd Lichty was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
And Tim, you were just saying he was a nice guy, weren't you? I mean...
Are we saying it was Andrew Valdinas'
fault? I've got no idea. I didn't even see it happen.
But you're making an inference, I would assume.
No, John, I thought John was saying that he saw Valdinas actually do it. Accidentally, of course, that was
exactly
what he was saying.
That's where I saw the contact coming from, and I have no doubt it was completely legitimate in the phase of the game.
And unintentional.
Yep.
Hey, things like that happen. You can't play a game like this and expect not to get hit occasionally.
I'm only commentating. I've just got one behind the lug hole from John Gardner for putting him in. It's 78-67. Here's Grace floater. Doesn't go. Crawford. Weak side rebound and gets the two. Crawford has eight.
First points for James Crawford since three-quarter time. He goes to eight.
Orlando Williams is sitting down, which would it be surprised to you two?
I'm a little surprised, but I won't be surprised if he gets back in fairly soon. He's had a good long break. He's going to be refreshed. Ooh, that'll be a holding foul. Valdinas really taking off.
He wasn't happy about that either, John.
No, he wasn't. Well, you know, of course, Mike, the thing that happens or tends to happen, as you well know, is that there was contact both ways. But when you're struggling for rhythm and you want to get your game back on track, you tend to take all of these contacts a little personally, and you can't quite understand why you're missing the shots you'd normally make. But let's give him a chance on the foul line.
Well, Grace didn't want him to try and get the dunk, so he's just gone for the big hack. Had a shot at the ball, missed, got his arm. But, you know, that's understandable. He doesn't want Geelong to get off with a big dunk by Valdinas.
Valdinas has done what he has to do. He's made the two. 11 points the margin. Just over 8.5 minutes remaining. Geelong are still within striking distance, and they've got that man Williams back on the floor. A couple of three-pointers from him will really make it interesting. That'll be a travel. That'll be a walk. Ricky Grace.
Damn it.
Yep.
That was, it wasn't too bad. Actually went inside to that foul line that we were talking about, John.
Yeah.
Got it there. I thought they could have probably worked a little harder at maybe looking at Crawford. Crawford could have moved inside a little more down on that baseline.
Yeah, they really need, well, Michael, in my view, they need to attack the zone from inside out, not outside in. If they can get it through there, have the defense moving, make the penetration, find the open man, then really it's a much easier shot. It can become a catch-and-shoot bucket from then. Valdinas backing in on Blahoff. Sapwell, he's looked in rhythm tonight. That one's short. Good rebound by Trehear.
Yeah, well done, Trehear. On the sides against Rayos.
Rayos and clean Crawford out, so Trehear really had to get that.
Blahoff trying to back his way to the bucket. Crawford in the corner is Grace. Does he get past Sapwell? No. Good defence by the Supercat. Here's Trehear through traffic. Gets in and then out, Crawford. 5 second shot clock. Bounce past to JC.
Oh, that was a fair effort by O's. Boy, he got up. Crawford was going to kill that. O's has come over on the rotation, and I tell you what, he'd be dead unlucky to get a foul on that.
I just thought it was a late call.
Let's pick it up now. It was a late call, and they would not have called it if the bucket had have gone in. But by the same token, good matching leap there from O's. Good control from Crawford as well.
Yeah, he did well in actually moving the ball. Once he realised it had been pinned, he's brought his arm around and moved it around.
And that's where he's actually collected the call from. But gee, great effort by O's.
James Crawford on the foul line.
Yes, Mike, it was a terrific effort by Ray O's. And even better now that James Crawford has missed the first from the line, Mike.
Well, that's right. That's what you do. If you can't stop them one way, you stop them another.
Scotty Fisher would love to be out there. James Crawford. 5 from 6 from the foul line. Simon Curl. Still a long time to go on this one.
Mike, I wonder if they've staunched the flow of blood. Here's Ray O's.
They've probably
had to bring it out. Had to bring it out. It's been a while.
I hope they've stopped it as well.
Here is Traher. To our viewers, John Gargan produced a word called staunch. It completely bemused Mike Ellis and yours truly for a while, but we hope Todd Lichty's okay in the dressing room.
Well, he hasn't come out, and I'd imagine when he does, he'll have a couple of neat stitches, and he at least won't have the bruising as they've opened it up a little bit. But Aaron Traher with the chance here to help his club creep a little bit further adrift from Geelong, who are still there.
Yes, Aaron Traher has 18 points. Vlahov has 22 to be the game-high scorer. Now Traher has 19. And we did mention that Scott Fisher wasn't playing, but of course he was the first here tonight at the Entertainment Centre. And he's sidelines. Just have a quick chat with you, Mike Ellis.
He is, yes. We've got Scotty with us. He obviously wants to be on the floor, but can't be. Scott, what do you make of the game so far?
Well, I think at times our defence has looked awesome. Unfortunately, we have had a lot of turnovers. Shooting wasn't very good in the first half, but I really like our defense today. You know, Crawford really came out to play. He's done a great job on O's, as has Vlahov. Traher's having a hell of a game. Ricky's a little down on confidence, but you know, that'll come later.
Well, just have a look at this, Mike. Here's Ricky Grace. Yeah, I thought he tripped over his own feet.
No, I think he got
Grace is gone.
A little trip from Sapwell, but don't underestimate the quick thinking of Grace. He was trying to call a timeout while he was sliding to the baseline.
There's Scott Ricky trying to call some timeouts while he's sliding on the ground. He thinks pretty quick on his feet, Rick, doesn't he?
on his bum. On his feet, yeah.
Here is Exum. Put the wall up against him in the margin. Is back to 12 points, 83-71.
Scott, you'd have to say Andrew's certainly relishing now that he's had a week at home. You must be feeling the same. It'd be good to get in your own bed again.
It's been very nice. I think we're finally over our jet lag. You know, we're sleeping well. Lobs looks very fresh tonight. You know, he's actually shown a bit more pace in his step than he has over the past month or so, and he's played very well. So I think he's enjoying it.
Oh, that was nice on the baseline there. O's and Hanson try and clean each other out. I wouldn't want to be in the middle of that one.
No, they both fell down rather heavily.
I think our first team has done, you know, excellent on defense, and we've been mixing it up a bit. And we got you know, three bench players on there right now, and our defense has just been a little bit erratic when these guys have come in. But they've been working hard. If we could rebound, talking about those offensive rebounds, we'd be in real good shape.
That's about right too. All right, Scotty, thank you very much. I'll let you get back to your cheering on the bench.
Thanks very much to Scott Fisher. Join Mike Ellis sidelines.
Well, Rupert Sapwell has come back in for a neat little putback, and there's a couple of signs that would worry the Wildcats. You can't allow Sapwell to just waltz in there and put it back. And if you look at the 12-point margin, you've got just under 6 minutes. Traher has gone off, and Stewart has stepped up from beyond the arc.
Anthony Stewart has 15 points to be the third high scorer for Perth.
Yeah, I mean, Simon Curl is such a dangerous player. He's penetrating with that right hand, looking to take the shot. He was able to get past the first line. Stewart was the defensive player at the other end. Stewart has 15 points and he's 3 from 5, 60% from the three-point line. Simon Curl has been quiet, only has 4 tonight, and really has been shooting at a 17-point average for the season so far. I think he and Williams, considering the job that they've done on O's so far, really hold the key for Geelong's success or demise out here in the last 5 minutes.
He's played certainly a different game to what he would normally play. For my John, he hasn't really looked
outside at all. He's really been concentrating on penetrating and trying to bring other people into the game, which, I mean, it's not a bad thing, but he certainly needs to look offensively from the arc as well, because he is dangerous out there.
Hasn't nailed one from the arc yet. He's 0 of 6 and 2 of 13 for the night at a woeful 15%. Here's Stewart again. Doesn't go. Vlahov handing to Grace. Catch and shoot by Ricky Grace. Doesn't go. Here's Williams. He'll do something. He'll get close to the arc and then just bomb away.
You're dead right. Went to the elbow on the left hand. Went up. Good rebound out there. And Grace pushes it down. You know, when you come back to Simon Curl, of course, he could add that third scoring medium that Geelong are really missing. So if he was on the ball with his shots and making a few more, could be a different scoreline.
Mike Ellis, Todd Lichty has returned to the sidelines, but we have a timeout at the Perth Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats lead by 13. They're 88. The Supercats are 75.
One family torn apart by the death of their father.
Sal McCarter battle.
Fighting a war they cannot win. Both caught in a catastrophic rift with the underworld.
Someone is stealing the bodies of the dead.
And the cruel truth lies with the gods.
First sign of evil, you start pointing your finger at gods and monsters.
Now,
it's a trap.
Hercules must tame Gregus, the dog of death.
Obviously, you're not a pet lover.
In an immortal showdown with the undead. It's the ancient world's darkest hour. Hercules, 7:30 tonight.
Can you see? Can you see it's new?
It's you. It's a new you.
Please consider the new Mitsubishi Lancer Coupe.
If you're looking for some great Father's Day gift ideas, then check Marlowe's 10-page Father's Day sale catalogue in the Sunday Times TV Extra magazine. There's great motoring bargains like these French knit car seat covers at just $23.50 a pair. Or what about a 275 PSI air compressor for only $129? And your stereo car radio cassette is just $29.95. But look, there's heaps of other specials, plus a chance to win a weekend holiday for two at the Broadwater Resort in Busselton. The entry form's in Marlowe's Father's Day sale catalogue in the TV Extra magazine.
It's elegant dining. It's quality dining. It's the Olive Tree Terrace Restaurant. For more than 10 years, the Olive Tree Restaurant has been well known for its warm, friendly service. Now specializing in personalized receptions and large private functions with seating up to 100 guests. Or you can pamper yourself with relaxed, comfortable dining with an intimate lunch or dinner. The Olive Tree Terrace Restaurant is the best value dining in Perth. Emerald Terrace, West Perth.
88-75, the gap is 13. 4:44 left in the fourth. Mike Ellis, Todd Lichty has returned.
He has returned. He's picked up a few stitches. In actual fact, I haven't had a chance to talk to Doc. He's just been in there cleaning up, so he's just returned. I will investigate and tell you the exact number shortly, but he's all cleaned up. Got a bandage on. Williams nearly made a lot out of nothing. But I say Lichty is ready to partake in the game again.
Tough shot by Williams, a little sign of desperation. And that's a much, much better control shot from Trehear. Desperation shot from Williams, that's a bad sign. It's a bad sign. If he's going to take the tough shots and make them, that's fine. But if he's just going to try and create everything, it won't work. Oh dear, there's no big pardons underneath the bucket either.
Vlahov just helped Rayos back down from where he was. Trehear has all of a sudden zoomed to 22. Vlahov has 22. It is here. Ray said, I'm going up. And Andrew said, no. Come on down.
Not this time. And, of course, that's the fourth team foul for the Wildcats, so they don't have any more to give without sending Geelong to the foul line. There's Curl. He can operate from that right-hand side. Like to see them push him left more than right. Ricky Grace, will he penetrate all the way? Pulls it up, tries to find Vlahov on the block. Geelong have gone back to man-to-man now. This should suit the Wildcats. They're patient in their offensive build-up. I think that Oz is just asking Vlahov a few questions out there.
Vlahov is making all the... big screen on Curl by Vlahov. And if that goes in, it's something special. And it does. Andrew Hare saw it as he was lying prostrate on the ground. He now has 24 game-high score. Here's Curl through traffic, moves to double figures.
And he went past four Wildcats players there. Trehear, of course, was just taking himself off the floor. There's another fairly large screen, and Scalzi has gone to the pick.
In out there by Stewart, rimmed around. Here's Sapwell to the left, should get it on the end. It's Crawford, hand on the body, same time the ball was on the other hand. No, the hand was on the other ball.
Might be
Put your teeth in and try again.
The right hand was on the ball while the left hand was on the body.
That's more like it.
Keep it simple.
You'll find that's about all she wrote for James Crawford.
James Crawford will sit down now with 6 fouls, 9 points and 6 rebounds. He is 5 from 6 from the foul line, 67% from the field. James Crawford, who's been a little bit down on points production this year at 14 against a career average of 24, has done a great job on Ray O's.
Yes, that's here's the first screen. Got a bit of Matt Scalzi. Mike Ellis, have we worked out the damage to Todd Lichty yet?
I have. He's actually had 5 quick ones, was the word.
5 stitches in the left cheek for Todd Lichty. We have another timeout here at the Entertainment Centre. 93 Perth, 79 the Supercat, 3 minutes left.
Been an interesting week for poor old Todd Lichty. Had back-to-back games across the nation. On the other side, last weekend, came back, had a touch of the flu, spent 2 or 3 days in bed before practice this week. Steps up for his first game for the Perth Wildcats at their home court and very politely gets opened up across the cheekbone. Field shooting percentage does favour the Wildcats, and they've been consistently at that 48-49%. Supercats have improved. They were well down on that 37 early. They're back to 41%, and that can be so damaging if they pick it up. Hurley has 3 minutes to go. Stacker has the same 3. And if we look at the shots from range, Wildcats at 53%, which is absolutely sensational when you consider you get the extra point for each shot taken against 25% for the visitors.
Matt Scalzi copped a big one from Vlahov, and so did Simon Kerr, but Simon, I think you just saw it coming.
What's this little finger roll? Yeah. This is when you've got to start to say the Wildcats have got a chance of winning this ball game. Very friendly roll.
93-79, Andrew Vlahov brings some his big body on the opposition. Pete Hansen's checked back into the game. Hasn't seen a lot of court time, but it'll take a while, John. You know, he's played with you in the SBL.
Well, Pete's been out here since 1988. Actually, Tim, he has been an Australian citizen for almost 3 years himself. So he's been out here for a long time, played with the Wildcats, played with the Perry Lakes Hawks in the SkyWest Basketball League. But it will take a little time to step to this tempo.
And for our viewers, of course, he had to make way for Scott Fisher.
That's right. That's exactly right. And you've got a lot of veterans on this Wildcat club now, a lot of people around the big 3-0 mark, and a lot of experience.
Looking forward to reaching the big 3-0 myself.
Oh, yeah?
I wish I was.
Yeah, I've got to say.
Well, mind you, I have too. That was that's one of those white ones a couple of years ago.
Got to say, Mike, I can remember just.
Simon Curl has just picked up his 3rd personal foul. Got 6 assists, Simon Curl, and 5 steals. So he's been okay, although he's just got the 10 points for the night and 0 of 6 from the arc. Yeah, which is unlike him.
That is, and this is the a foul from Scalzi, and that is the last they have to give. I suspect we may see a fairly brutal last 2.5 minutes here from Geelong. They're not going to give anything up. We've got a line up here. You'll see Grace goes down. The second man comes high. Third man comes across. They're really trying to get the ball into the play, and then they'll work some sort of pick and roll, which is what we see here. High post entry to Vlahov. Oh, gee, there's no big pardons as Vlahov goes left. You'll find Stewart, and the Wildcats will be content to go inside only if there's a give me, but they will really be looking with 8 seconds on the clock to take the low jumper from Vlahov, and it's good.
So the gap is 15 points.
It's cool again on the right hand. You just cannot let him go right. Like it doesn't count. Suspect it will go and put Curl to the foul line. Gee, there's not a lot of anxious defense there. Simon Curl on the foul line. Michael Butler hands in the ball. First one. Whoa! Had a look at every vantage point from the top and just didn't drop in. Simon Curl generally is good. 73% from the foul line. That one's better. Now we'll see a little extended defense here from Geelong. They've got to be desperate. They're trying to deny Grace the ball, which they're doing very effectively. Trahair comes back to clean up. Trahair and Curl will foul him. That will be his 4th foul. That's his fourth. It'll send Aaron Trahear to the foul line.
Underneath 2 minutes to go, the Wildcats 95, the Supercats are 81, and the Supercats have to go to Adelaide.
They do go to Adelaide on Sunday, which is a tough double, made somewhat easier by the fact that in past years they've played a back-to-back situation here, then in Adelaide the next night, or vice versa. So at least they do have a day off, and they could beat Adelaide.
We haven't seen the best of Todd Lichty tonight as far as points production is concerned, but I'm sure the fans would have been relatively impressed with their first-hand look at him.
Well, I think they're suitably impressed, and boy, they'll be impressed with that one. Oh!
He loves it, doesn't he?
He sure does. There's not much of him out there, and what is he, 6'2" at best, and he takes that rainbow jumper.
And he shot that from where I'm standing.
Gee, I can hardly see it, let alone watch it go in.
Pretty impressive stuff.
How are the hot dogs where you're standing?
Sure, they're not too bad. They're a bit cold, actually. But, Tim, I think I might have organised what you're wondering about, too.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you understand sign language, and I'm glad the viewers can't see anything we've been doing for the last couple of minutes.
I understood it. I just couldn't do it. I now can.
We're looking forward to your post-game interview, Mike Ellis.
Cut your hands off next time, Gossage.
Sorry, John. Sign language, you don't understand. Here's Grace on the line, makes the second. He's got 9 points. He's got 8 assists. He's got 8 rebounds. He's got 3 steals. So it's all been pretty good.
Ooh, lucky to come away with that without an offensive. Little pump fake from Williams. Gee, that's not a bad rebound from Scalzi either, do O's. Quick hands there by Hansen.
I thought you meant by O's, by just hanging on the rim there.
He's had a fairly good game, O's. I mean, really, he's been scoring at 21 for the season. He's got something like 349 points for the season so far. And he stepped up here tonight, and he has 13, and he's got 8 rebounds. But he has been a marked man. Everybody has collapsed on Ray O's. Wildcats have set out to take him out of the game, but he's still been very, very serviceable out there against some very quality defense.
Well, mate, he hasn't thrown the towel in, has he? I mean, he's just kept working hard and working hard, and he's worked very hard at the defensive end too, John.
Yeah, he has, and he's had some big bodies to match up, and not a lot of help, I'd have to say. Sapwell's been out there, but really, they are a big man short, Geelong, and they're probably an outside shooter short. I know that Williams has shown us that he can, but Curl's been missing from the three-point line. He's none from six. I mean, if he makes what he normally makes from that three-point situation at about 38-40%, there's another 7 or 8, maybe 10 points.
John Scalzi normally can fill it up fairly well from outside. How's his stats looking tonight?
Scalzi has not been impressive. He's none from four. So I guess, Mike, the point that we're making is none from 10. There is at least a dozen points gone missing that they would normally expect to get from those two players.
Here is Scalzi. Trahear has 27 points. A big Trey, and he's into the 30s.
I think it'll be fairly clinical from now on. There's not a lot that they can do, Geelong. Wildcats won't be anxious to take the shots, won't be anxious to go to the foul line. It's pretty much keeping off, looking to come out, spread the floor. They don't want that foul. They will take it. And of course, Trahear is fairly accurate from the foul line at 71%. But it's not necessarily their preferred option. They've made the ton. 100 plays 86 as Aaron Trahear goes to the foul line. He's had a good game, Tim.
He certainly has. He's got 27 points to this time. He's 3 assists. He's got 5 defensive rebounds. He's 4 of 7 from beyond the arc. And on the line, he is 8 of 9 at 89%.
Tim, he had 8 points at half time. So he has stepped up and had a big second half.
Yep. And now he's moved to 29.
Curl goes left, decides to go all the way, but dishes. I guess that's the answer as well, Mike. They've put some fairly good defense on Scalzi.
Yeah, they have. The rotation's been very good, I think, just for a little spat in that start of the third quarter, they were down, but other than that, they were good. 3 seconds, Stewie, I thought they were going to call.
And if he'd have missed it, the house would have come down.
Anthony Stewart has 17. Oh, here we go again. Orlando's just not going to die wondering. Man, good tip in by Scalzi. Williams' 17 attempts from beyond the arc is the second most by a Geelong player.
Well, he's not going to ever die wondering what his form will be from the three-point line. Anthony Stewart will come down to have a little foul shooting practice.
20 points for Orlando Williams. Rayo's 15, Rupert Sapwell 15, and Simon Curl has slipped in with 14. And for the Wildcats, Trehear has 29, Vlahov 24, Stewart on the line 17, and Lichty, who's sitting down with a cut to the left cheek, has 11 and 5 stitches.
11 points, 11 rebounds, 4 assists, 5 stitches.
It's a quadruple double. It's interesting too, Tim, if you look at the season's averages out there, Geelong have been scoring at a clip of about 95 per game and giving up 105, so they're just about on the mark. Wildcats have been scoring at 98 while giving up 95, so both of these teams, score-wise, have been pretty much near their average.
Stewart has 18, so 105 Perth, 91 Geelong. Wildcats stamp their authority on this game from quarter time onwards. Skelzy in the corner, doesn't go.
Well, this will be a prayer. I wouldn't think Geelong would foul. Oh, Stewart's gone to the car park to retrieve what Ricky Grace has thrown. Gone out the door, and Stewie is, I don't think he's even going to get up.
Ricky was hoping that he'd get fouled at the foul line, up at the halfway line.
That's the final score at the Perth Entertainment Centre. The Wildcats have resumed on home territory with a victory, 105-91. There'll be no time for an interview. We'll go to a break. The Wildcats are winners.
Tuesday, it should be a time to come together.
You miss your family, right?
But you're here.
But these holidays are going to be a little different.
Is Kelly going to be around this weekend?
This time, they're on their own.
I have the house to myself tonight.
90210, 7:30 Tuesday on 10.
If you're looking for some great Father's Day gift ideas, then check Marlowe's 10-page Father's Day sale catalogue in the Sunday Times TV Extra magazine.
There's great motoring bargains like these 40-piece tool kits at just $16.95. Well, what about a 1,400 kilogram trolley jack at a bargain price of $33? And 5 litres of Castrol GTX2 engine oil is just $15.50. But look, there's heaps of other specials, plus the chance to win a brand new Daihatsu Charade with selected Castrol purchases. So get your Marlowe's Father's Day sale catalogue in the TV Extra magazine.
Hi, you drive that sporty Holden Calibra, don't you?
Fully imported from Germany. And you, that big performance HSV, right?
Yeah, right. Sheer brute Holden power.
Did you buy it from City Motors?
Absolutely.
Me too.
Let's do it.
See you tomorrow. City Motors
is in Newcastle Street.
They want to manipulate your mind.
This device is stimulating electrical activity in the brain.
Control your every move.
Car's been moved. Did you take it out last night?
Your greatest fear could become reality.
He's here to kill me.
I'm here to help you, Scully.
The X-Files, 8:30 Wednesday.
105-91, a 14-point win for the Perth Wildcats, and John Gardner, a fairly clinical effort.
Yeah, great effort. They did what they had to do. They came to win, and they brought that about.
Let's take a look at the top scorers then for both teams.
Well, Trehear stepped up and had a very big second half. Vlahov was solid all night. Williams was great from range, and Oz, I thought, had a very good game.
So the Wildcats have returned winners here in Perth after the Olympic break, 105-91. John Gardner, thanks very much for your time. Also to Mike Ellis and also the hard-working 10 sports crew here at the Perth Entertainment Centre. The final score, Perth 105, Geelong 91. Until next time, it's goodbye.
The Mitsubishi Challenge, proudly brought to you by Chicken Treat. I've got the taste. Coca-Cola, always jammin', always Coca-Cola. Ian Diffen, World of Tires. McDonald's, where it's Mac time. And Mitsubishi, please consider.
He's got the magic.